Hey everyone, welcome back to the New England Aquarium, virtually that is. My name is Nick. Thanks for tuning in to check out what's happening with us here. In front of me, you'll see that I have a lobster. This is a blue lobster. We like lobsters quite a bit here at the aquarium. We display them in exhibits. We take them out for presentations. We also have a lab up on the fifth floor where we study them. One of the things that we get a lot from our visitors in terms of questions about lobsters is how to properly handle a lobster. And that's actually kind of a good skill to know anyway. So I'm gonna demonstrate that. Now lobsters, they have two big claws on the front of their body and those claws are very strong. So obviously for a human interacting with a lobster, it's important to avoid those claws if you can. And so we have some sort of techniques that we like to use when we handle our lobsters that kind of minimize any exposure to claws, keep the lobster very safe, and I'll kind of demonstrate that right now. Now, if I was taking this lobster out for a presentation, well, I do have an ice pack in the water to keep the water nice and cold because lobsters like cold water. I would normally have an aerator as well to be injecting air into the water so the lobster can breathe properly. But that's usually for times when the lobster is out for a longer period of time. We're just gonna take this lobster out for a second here, so I don't have the aerator right now. I'm gonna take the ice pack out of the water so you guys can see a little bit better. Now I'm gonna be using my right hand here. I'm gonna gently grab the lobster behind its claws on its carapace, firmly enough to keep the lobster from springing out of my grasp, but not too firm that you might actually damage the lobster, because even with those hard shells, we could even potentially damage them if we're not careful. I'm gonna actually use the back end of a net here to kind of distract the lobster from the front, and then I'm gonna reach in and take my thumb and my pointer finger and put it right behind the lobster's claws to kind of isolate them from being able to reach back towards me and gently lift the lobster out of the water. So there you go. You can see our lobster, and I know this lobster is a male because the top set of swimmerettes, those little appendages on their tail, is hard and pointed. That means this is a male lobster. Now when I put the lobster back into the water, I'm going to do something called burping the lobster, and that's when I sort of twisted lobster in gently to prevent any air from getting caught underneath their body, because that can make things kind of uncomfortable for these animals. So there you go, our lobster's right back into the tank. No harm, no foul. Thanks for tuning in to learn more about how to properly handle lobsters. Come back and see us soon.